Health care bill. Is that right?
Well, actually, Mr. President, this is the Senate bill, along with the 11-page okay. proposal that you put up online that really, I think, is a basis for the discussion here. So, I do want to go back to your suggestion as to why we're here. And you suggested that maybe we are here to find some points of agreement to bridge the gap in our differences. And I do like to go back to basics. We're here because we Republicans care about health care just as the Democrats in this room. And when the Speaker cites her letters from the folks in Michigan and the leader talks about the letters he's received, Mr. Andrews his, all of us share the concerns when people are allegedly wronged in our health care system. I mean, I think that is sort of a given. We don't care for this bill. I think you know that. The American people don't care for the bill. I think that we've demonstrated in the polling that they don't. But there is a reason why we all voted no. And it does have to do with the philosophical difference that you point out. It does have to do with our fear that if you say that Washington can be the one to define essential health benefits, there may be a problem with that. And that's the language in the section 1302 of this bill, that it says that the secretary shall define for people what essential health benefits are. But let's, in the spirit of trying to come together, let's try and say maybe if we assume that Washington could do that, could really take the place of every American and decide what is most essential, What would be the consequences? And that's also where we have a big difference in this bill and what would happen. First of all, the cost. And John.